Dear students, today I am going to teach you the chapter Force and Pressure. So, in this chapter, there are two important terms. One is force and another one is pressure. So, first of all, we will try to understand what is basically the force. In our day-to-day life, we have come across various actions such as picking something, opening the door or shutting the door or window, kicking a ball, hitting, lifting, flicking, pushing, pulling are often used to describe certain tasks. Now, these actions usually results in some kind of change in the state of motion of an object. This line is very much important. That is, each and every actions, every such actions brings some change in the state of motion of the object. So, all these terms can be replaced with one or more common terms. Here's some pictures are there. For example, the goalkeeper is trying to save the goal by catching the ball, or this is a hockey player flicking a ball, or a fielder stopping a ball in a cricket match. So these actions can be categorized either into pull or push or both. So in science, this push or pull on an object is called as force. Thus we can say that the motion imparted to objects was due to the action of a force. Now, why force appears? This is a very important question. For example, if we consider a car, a stationary car, and a man who is standing behind this stationary car. Now, when this man pushes the car, then the car starts to move or may start to move. So when the car moves when it is pushed by an external agency. Here the external agency is the man who is pushing the car. So we can see that there are two objects which must interact upon each other, and in this way force arises. So this is another important question related to the reason of origin of force. Thus we can infer that at least two objects must interact for a force to come into play. Thus an interaction of one object with another object results in a force between the two objects. Now we will know some more details about the force. Here you can see a block which is being pushed by two boys. These two boys are pushing this block in the same direction. So the force applied by them is in the same direction, and hence the net force, net means total, the total force will be the sum of these two forces. But here we can see that the block is pushed by two boys but in opposite direction. So the net force or the total force will be the difference of these two forces. Suppose the magnitude of this force is 50 and the magnitude of this force is 30. So the net force will be 20. That is 50 minus 30 is 20. And here if the force applied by these two boys are 50 and 30 respectively, the net force will be 50 plus 30, that is equal to 80. Here we can also see the example of tug of war. Here we can see that sometimes the rope may not move if the two teams pull at with the equal force. We will later come to it. So before this, we are again reading the highlighted portion. This portion states that forces applied on an object in the same direction add to one another, and if the two forces act in the opposite directions on an object, the net force acting on it is the difference between the two forces. So we learned that a force could be larger or smaller than the other or equal to each other. The strength of a force is usually expressed by its magnitude. Later we will come to know that force has one SI unit known as Newton. Now we go back to our previous example of tug of war. Here it is written that the rope may not move if the two teams pull it with equal force. That is, when the two teams pull the rope with equal amount of force, then it may not move. It is always seen in this game. And when the force exerted by one team is higher than the other, then they win. So how this happens? Actually, here we can see that the two forces, that is the two pulling forces, are in opposite direction. As earlier we have said that the resultant of two forces acting in opposite direction is the net difference between these two forces. So when these two forces are equal, when these two pulling forces are equal, then the net resultant will be zero. Suppose this is 50 and suppose this is 50 amount of force is applied on this side and 50 amount of force is applied on that side. So the net force will be 50 minus 50, that is equal to zero. So here is a question: does it mean that the net force on an object is zero if the two forces acting on it in opposite directions are equal? Yes, the net force will be zero. So I have prepared also a note on this topic which I have taught so far. So please go through this note, and I will also assign some home tasks and do it on your copy.